taken in at the three. And a good return as he'll be stopped just shy of the 30-yard line. So here's the Viking offense making their way out. And leading them out there, we get a look at their 6'3 quarterback.
And what's a quarterback's best friend?
Balance.
I think you're right. I agree with you. You know, a lot of guys would say great receiver, right? A terrific offensive line. But I agree with you, balance, because if you can run the ball effectively, that just opens things up for guys who want to throw it and gives you easier passing lanes and easier coverages to read.
And they said balance will be a focus in this one.
Yeah, they don't want it all just heaped on his shoulders, I don't believe. I think they want to make sure they take some of the pressure off.
That's going to be knocked away and incomplete. He was trying to find Justin Jefferson there, but it'll be second down. Here's a play fake as they set up to throw. Being chased out left. And oh, right away, he lost the football. Now whistles and a timeout. Looks like we've got a Viking slow to get up. More from LA in a moment. First and 10, here's Mond dancing to his left. Nowhere to go here, he lost the football. But a Viking was able to corral this one, and Minnesota will keep possession. Second time in this game, Charles, the ball has squirted out from his hands. Luckily, his teammate was there to pounce on it.
You're right, got the lucky bounce, able to retain possession. You know, we often talk about the combine, and why do we measure quarterbacks' hands? Is that really a big deal? It's for situations like this. Do you have the hands big enough and strong enough to hold onto the football while being jostled?
Well, that'll be incomplete. Well, he took a shot as he let that go. And it's going to bring up a third down. An incomplete pass on that last play. To his left. Now he'll let it go on the run. Deep left side. And this is dropped. Oh boy. A chance for a big play early, but he could not secure it. And look at this. They're keeping the punter on the sideline. They're going to go for it here on the opening drive. They're going to try and throw. He's going to take another shot here. Oh, a contested ball here, and it's going to be caught. And he'll be taken down deep into Charger territory. Fourth down conversion plays, you usually think 1, 2, 3 yards, maybe 10. Not there. What a huge pickup as the sticks make a drastic shift forward. Inside the red zone here, they'll look to throw. Now the pressure gets there, and he goes down just inside the 20 at the 19. Ochenna Nwosu. Able to get in there for his second sack of the afternoon. To try again after the sack. Jones. He turned that into a nice gain. Gets him 8 yards closer for third down. Throwing Jones on the move to it, and he can't get rid of it. He's taken down. Ochenna Nwosu getting him once again, his third sack of the afternoon.
And that sack there, that likely brings out the field goal unit, so they might have to settle for three here on their opening drive.
They did some nice things, getting things started there, moving the ball downfield, but taking that sack on third down.
Touchdown, Vikings! KJ Osborne. From 21 yards away. And the Vikings take the ball down the field and score on their opening drive.
CD, that call, it took some guts. It's not like they were at the 1 yard line. They had some distance to go.
They certainly did. And, you know, a lot of people might say that's fly by the seat of your pants type of coaching. But it's also sending a message out there. We're going to be unpredictable. You can't prepare for anything with us. You never know which way we're going to go. We zig, you zag.
And now some serious opening drive momentum. Extra point right down the middle. And that makes the score 7-0.
Now Joseph tees it up to kick off following the touchdown. Here comes Nasir Adderley from his end zone. Adderley, he's going to hold on to this one. A touchback and the drive will begin at the 25.
So here's the Charger offense making their way out. So now this offense will take over and they will have the football at their own 20-yard line. Now Jones steps away to his left. Lets it fly for Thielen. A fight for it, and this is caught. It's caught indeed.
Boy, they've definitely come out of the gate smoking here in the first quarter. Whatever they've tried to run has worked, and there's another example right there. Game plan is one thing, but how about his accuracy? It's been exceptional.
Now on the run, he'll throw it back deep over the middle. Thrown across his body, and it's intercepted. Picked off by Michael Davis. And a big turnover there as his guys will get the football back. So cancel the interception, pass interference.
And you know what else gets canceled? The return yardage. Makes the play, but now it's all for naught.
Back to throw. Jones forced out to his left. And he will score. Touchdown, Vikings.
Mac Jones,
an 8-yard touchdown run.
And the Vikings are able to strike quickly to add on to their lead.
Defensively, didn't seem like anybody had eyes on the quarterback, and he took advantage.
So you think that maybe we're seeing...
After a good punt, this offense will start with tough field position inside the 10. They go play action here on first down, eluding the pressure right. He's going to let this go deep, back over the middle.
And this is incomplete. Oh, it looked like he had a pretty good line on that one. That would have been a big play, but he could not pull it in.
To throw on second and 10. Jones buying time to his left. And they'll get him down right at around the 11-yard line. He'll end up getting 5 out of that, but now they're looking at third down. Looking to throw. Jones being chased out left. And he will get the first down as he's up to the 20-yard line. A good decision in the end to pull it and run, get some 9 yards at a first.
We have so many different terms for third down, third and short, third and long, third and manageable. How about third and medium? Because that's what this one was. The defense looked like they had him hemmed in, but he gets away, evades the rush, and picks up just enough for the first down.
And this one is incomplete.
KJ Osborne, the one he was looking for.
And that'll bring up second down. To throw again. Jones dancing to it. Now the pressure comes and he goes down. Just inside the 10, back at the 9. Ochenna Nwosu. Who else? He's in there for his 4th sack of the afternoon. Here's Jones throwing on 3rd and long. And that's going to wind up incomplete. However, we do have a flag down. Let's check in with our referee.
So pass interference to call. That's going to set him up with a first down.
And if it's a bang-bang play, maybe the flag stays in the official's pocket, but instead, he definitely impeded the receiver's right to catch the football. The official's letting the players know how the game's going to be called here in the first quarter.
And he's going to get a solid gain of 9 before being brought down, 2nd and right at a yard. Now the first carry for Dalvin Cook. And he'll get it out a couple yards shy of midfield at the 48.
2nd and 1, and people want to run the football. This is where every back in the league is supposed to do exactly what we just saw there. Pick up the first down.
They run, Cook.
And he's going to be brought down on what will be the final play of this first quarter. 14-0 the score. This is the NFL on EA Sports. Throwing on second and three. Jones flushed out right. Jones hit and the ball's out. And picked up by the Chargers. And his guys are going to take over at the 39-yard line. Here are the Vikings now to start their next drive. And last time, the fumble, the turnover. Now they still have the lead, but I don't think coaches care. The turnovers will bother them no matter what the scoreboard says.
That's the relief, that you still have the lead. But coaches look at what if and what it should be. Turning the ball over when they get a chance to score more points and increase the lead, that's what's going to affect them.
And they're also thinking to future weeks, maybe when the game's closer, right?
No doubt about it. You want to clean up everything. Let's just be honest about it. They want everything to be...
And now look at this. Big gain, but a fumble. And picked up by the Chargers. And they'll start out with great field position at the 47-yard line in enemy team. So the football will be at the 25-yard line as this offense gets set to take over. Back to throw. Fields steps away to his left. And he can't find a receiver, and he's brought down. Ojeda Nwosu. My goodness, make that now 5 sacks for him in this ball game. Really, really turning in an incredible performance. They come up on second and long, and the pass protection just has not been there this afternoon. Escaping the pressure right. And they'll bring him down at the 27-yard line. A nice job of eluding the pressure there, scrambling for 11. The Vikings on third down, just 1 for 3 thus far. This is 3rd and 8. Now it's Fields. Oh, going for Jefferson downfield. And this will be incomplete. Both players with a shot at it that time, but neither coming away with it. And this offense has converted twice already here in this first half on fourth down conversions. And here we go again. So certainly an interesting call there to go for it. And the... With a little over 2 minutes to play in the second quarter, the offense gets ready to take over. A play fake, now Fields to throw. Oh, going for Jefferson downfield. Launches deep. A jump ball, and this is caught. The post route proves effective, although it took a pretty good catch from his receiver to make it effective.
And what really makes it effective? When you have a little bit of clearance in the middle of the field and give him an opportunity to work at the least one-on-one with the defender.
They'll fake the handoff. Now Fields. Out to his left. He's going to let this go. Back of the end zone. And he knocks the ball away, and it falls incomplete. They were looking for Johnson that time. And now it's second down. Fields now to throw. They'll roll him out right. There he goes inside the 30. And he'll be taken down at the 26. A nice job there on the escape and scramble. A first down, a 16-yard gain. Now Fields. He's going to take a shot for the end zone. And it's caught in the end zone for the Viking touchdown by Justin Jefferson. Justin Jefferson, 26 yards. And the Vikings are going to widen that advantage.
A sensational one-handed grab in the end zone for the score. Looked like you at the Davis Turkey Bowl every year in the backyard in Orlando, Florida.
Oh, you're so kind. That's definitely in my mind. But how about this? They always...
Here are the Vikings now to start their next drive. And maybe some renewed pressure on this unit following the touchdown a moment ago. It's back to a one-score game.
And because of that pressure, because it's now a one-score game, they know this is where you need to slow the momentum change, because otherwise that could overrun your team. You've got to be careful right here.
And it'll be incomplete. Good job staying with him defensively. And it'll bring up second down. Oh, going for Jefferson downfield. It's caught inside the 25.
On any given pass play, you never know exactly where your exit points are going to be. On this play, he was flushed to his left, still on the run, able to accurately throw the football for a nice first down.
Forced out to his left. And Thielen's got it. Touchdown, Vikings. Thielen there to make the grab, and the Vikings find a way to stretch their lead, and they use that height on the outside to get the score.
We've seen the evolution of the wide receivers. They've gotten taller and taller, but they've retained their quickness and their speed.
Here are the Vikings now to start their next drive. They've been rolling the last couple of drives, each ending in touchdowns. So this game is flipped. They were down, now they're up with the football. We'll see how they handle it.
Can we get a spy on the headset now between the head coach and offensive coordinator?
It got his man complete. And he finally goes down, but not before reaching the 21.
Pretty good timing. He waited just enough for that post play to develop and laid it right in there.
And you know what a lot of teams do when they decide to throw a post route? Because it's a little bit longer developing play, they max protect. Bring everyone in, keep the tight end in, an extra back to make sure the quarterback has time to deliver the football.
Nice work to get seven out of that, and it's second down. Here's Fields. Buying time to his left. And it's caught in the end zone for the Viking touchdown by Justin Jefferson. Justin Jefferson, his second touchdown of the afternoon. And the Vikings are going to add on to their lead.
So a heck of a drive right there with the game potentially hanging in the balance.
A very good drive.
Here are the Vikings now to start their next drive. Their lead back down to one score after the field goal a moment ago, so they'll be looking to string together a few first downs, likely on the ground as they begin first and 10.
Steps away, and now he'll let this one go deep, back over the middle.
There's Jefferson to pull that in, and he gets all the way down to the 30-yard line.
Sometimes the one-handed catches are unnecessary, but he was trying to ward off the defender with the other, so maybe there that was just a good play.
So that tells you that not only do they imagine those types of catches, they actually work on them with defenders jostling them in order to keep their concentration and haul it in.
First down, here's the run with Cook. He'll be dropped at the 25 after a gain of 6.
If you can keep getting gains like that, Charles, with the lead here in the fourth quarter, I mean, keep running it, right?
No doubt about it. But what the offense coordinator has to do is understand they're going to continue to stack the line of scrimmage. What runs do you have in your arsenal that'll work against a stacked box and continue to move the ball? Had the right idea there, trying to throw it to the sideline, but he led him just a little bit too much, trying to get it out to his receiver. Ends up falling to the ground incomplete.
And look at this. They get the turnover they needed. It's intercepted. Picked off by Michael Davis. And he's able to get it back to right around the 27.
Vikings now to start their next drive. Right now clinging to a one-score lead, Charles, and I think operating within that four-minute offense with a little less than 4 minutes to go applies here, right?
It certainly does, and that means the playbook is still wide open. But you...
Oh, a leap, and he will make the catch. And he makes it all the way down to the 19. A real field flipper there as all of a sudden they've got a first down in the red zone. A give to Cook out of the gun. And able to fight forward inside the 15 to the 13. It's a 7-yard carry to set them up with a second and three. Fields. Flush to his right. Oh, no, he lost the football. And picked up by the Chargers.
Well, partner, here's where team football gets.
Here are the Vikings now to start their next drive. And they had the fumble last time that led to a touchdown. That's a no-no. We'll see what they do here this go-around.
A big no-no. Put that in capital letters. Turning it over, the other team takes it down and scores. That can be a deflator for a football team. Now it's up to the offense to get back out on the field and pick things up.
Now they're out there. We'll see if they can pick those things back up. Following the incomplete pass, here they go again. Second and 10 from the 25. He'll look to throw, rolling to his left, and he can't get a throw away. He's taken down. Ochenna Nwosu in there to take him down, and the clock will roll. So it's third and long, and defensively not a real surprise there in the dime. Completes this to Jefferson, and he'll be taken down, but not before they work it across midfield. They needed some type of a miracle there at the very end, but they couldn't get it done. However, we were treated to really a spectacular affair.
Even though they didn't finish it off, you're exactly right. They took us down to the last play. We're still, you're wondering, could it happen? Possibly, even though we both knew it was a long shot.